Good morning students, welcome back to the second video. We were discussing the 100 dresses written by Eleanor Estes. Although in your book the name suggests Elsor Estes, which is actually wrong. It is Eleanor Estes, the correct name, and it is, I told you, based on a true life anecdote of Eleanor, the author, who is a famous children's story writer. We have gone through the introduction of Wanda and the dress game. So doing a quick recap, who was Wanda? Wanda's full name was Wanda Petronski. She was a Polish immigrant. She was very poor. She lived at Boggins Heights, where no other students of his school lived. So she had to come school all alone and go back to home all alone. Second thing was that she had no friends in the classroom. She sat at the back corner amidst the rough children of the school. Not because she was rough, but because she had no friends, and her shoes were always caked with mud because the road, the way from Boggins Heights to the school, she had to walk over mud to reach it. She had no friends, but she had a girl named Peggy, who was the most popular girl, prettiest girl of the school, and she devised a game, dress game. Point was, how did they trouble Peggy? So we have to remember two things. First thing, how did they trouble Wanda? First thing they did was that they made fun of her name because it was uncommon, which bordered on racial discrimination. And the second thing, she was poor. Everybody knew for the fact that she had only one faded blue dress, which was shabby but always clean. And she came to school in that very dress every day. So it was obvious she was poor and she has only one dress. But Peggy would ask her with a very fake polite voice, how many dresses you have? And what would Wanda reply? Wanda, instead of crying or feeling bad about herself, she would with a plain face reply, I have 100 dresses and 60 pair of shoes. They would, with false admiration, they would go, oh, and then they would ask about the details of the cloth, which color, what stitch, how it has been put, and so on and so forth. And once Wanda would leave, and Wanda would give detailed description of everything, every dress, she would describe 100 different dresses with her words. And once Wanda had left, they would break into a huge laughter, roar of laughter, because they all knew she was lying. It was impossible for her to have 100 dresses, because then she wouldn't have come to school in the same dress every day. Now we take it forward. A bright blue day. Now we bring in our character Maddie, who was the best friend of Peggy. Now Maddie felt sad about it. Maddie disliked Peggy's habit of playing this game of having fun with Wanda. Why? Maddie herself was poor. Just because Maddie lived in the town, her mother worked as domestic help in people's house, the dresses Maddie wore were hand-me-down clothes of Peggy. Right? The mother would do some alterations on the dress so that people wouldn't find out. Right? So she wanted to stop. First, she begins with thinking, what was the first time they began to play that game? And Wanda had told them that they had 100 dresses. So Maddie became sad when she did so, because she was poor. She understood the condition, the mental state and the financial condition of the girl. She lived in Boggin Heights, so there was not many people who could afford donating their used clothes as Maddie got. And Maddie's best friend was Peggy, so nobody really bothered about her financial condition. But, or she was, maybe Wanda was, she also felt that maybe Wanda was even more poor than her, because Boggins Heights, they wouldn't get much highly paying job over there. So in every sense, she had a very deep sympathy for Wanda. But she never dared to stand up against Peggy. Now, she was never able to gather the courage to stand up against Peggy. Now, what could be the reason? There were several reasons for that. A, the dresses Maddie wore were hand-me-downs of Peggy. With certain alterations the mother gave him, maybe others could recognize, but Peggy could will surely recognize they were her dresses. The second thing, that Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. Going against Peggy would mean going against the entire school. The entire school will suddenly become her enemy. She could become the next target after Wanda. Maybe Peggy decides to break friendship with her and begin playing the same game. How many dresses you have with Maddie? That would be very embarrassing for Maddie, because the dresses she wore were, all the dresses she had were hand-me-downs of Peggy. Right? Maybe Peggy would disclose it to the school that she is poor, as her mother is a maid and all the clothes she wears are mine. Basically, it's our family support that gives them a livelihood. So this was the risk. She didn't want to be the target of the entire school suddenly. And she also said that had Peggy not invented the dress game, perhaps Maddie wouldn't have noticed Wanda. The way Wanda stayed aloof from everybody, Maddie wouldn't have bothered looking at Peggy. Now she felt, what if Peggy actually starts playing that game with her, how many dresses you have, how embarrassing could it be? Just for the reason that dresses were Peggy's. And second thing, she thought, I am not as stupid as Wanda that I will claim I have 100 dresses and 60 pairs of shoes. But it's not a matter what answer I give. So in any case, even if she couldn't answer like Wanda, make up a story and tell it on the spot, even if everybody knew it was a lie, she would be embarrassed anyway undergoing that. But she wanted Peggy to somehow stop it. She was thinking of a way that she could stop Peggy from actually embarrassing the little girl in front of the entire school, because it hurt Maddie. For the simple reason, she could understand the plight perhaps Wanda was going through. Right? So that was the reason. I told you Maddie didn't stand up to Peggy because she was afraid Peggy would start making fun of her too. And the reason for that fear was, once again, the dresses Peggy had were actually the hand-me-downs of Peggy. By hand-me-downs I mean these were Peggy's clothes. After a few months, after wearing them for a few months, she handed it over to Maddie's mother, who did some alterations in the dress so that people doesn't recognize, and second thing about the name, she also didn't like this game of making fun of people's name, so she was against that too. But Maddie somehow changed her mindset. She concentrated on the art contest that was coming up in their school. She was sure the girls had to draw designs of clothes in the contest and boys had to draw designs of motorboat. Everybody was sure that Peggy would win because she was the best painter in the classroom, best artist. That's why she was best at studies, good looking, outgoing, and she was also best artist in her classroom. So that will be all in this video. I will meet you again with the final, third and final video of the story. Till then, Goodbye, take care all of you.